This is my Ryobi 18 volt 1 plus electric power blower. Comes with its own battery pack. It's electric powered and it has a brushless motor. And as you can see right down the shaft, there's the impeller fan that makes the gust of wind that goes out this end here. And there's the switch that turns it on or off. It's very lightweight and very easy to use. It actually weighs about 4.5 pounds with the battery pack on. It's very compact and you can port it around easily. And it blows 200 cubic feet per minute at about 90 miles per hour. So if you're doing debris cleaning work or if you're drying cars off, then yeah, this is definitely the perfect one to do that. Because like if either you're doing landscaping or debris work on a budget, then this one is a good choice. And this one cost me about $100 in total with the battery pack. Considering most blowers at around this type of class can go between $167 to over $320, which is crazy. And yes, that also includes the gas-powered versions as well, which are significantly heavier and larger than this, and even louder too. But this one, it's not too loud. It goes up to about 65 decibels of sound, so it's pretty decent. It's not too loud, actually. And this is where you attach the nozzle right here. You hook it up to this little peg here, and then it clips on just like that. And here is right down the barrel of it. You can briefly see the impeller fan right there. Now the motor is housed in this casing here. It's a brushless motor. And the battery pack hooks on to this end here. Now, the thing about the battery pack is it's detachable and it comes with its own charger. In fact, I'm gonna take it off or so like this. Just see here. So this is what the battery pack looks like. And then, as you can see, it plugs right into this unit right here. It plugs into the power cord right there. So once that's connected, then the blower will work. But if the battery pack is not on, then this will not work. So if I turn the switch on like this, it won't work. So in order to do that, I have to insert this back in like this, and then it clicks on just like that. Now, this battery pack, it's called the P190. It's a lithium ion, 18 volts, and about 36 watt hours of power. And since the battery pack is installed, I'm gonna demonstrate a sound test. As I said, it's not that loud. It only goes up to about 65 decibels. So I'm gonna go and turn this on and then. It's pretty quiet. Gets the job done, and it's very compact, very easy to maneuver around. This will clear out any leaves or debris or even water spots if you're doing various cleaning work of various kinds. And yeah, it's a good shot of the impeller fan right behind there. And it's very easy to carry around. The fact that it's really lightweight, I really like that idea. I mean, when it comes to electrical appliances, I really like this. It's pretty neat. And it's actually easier to use than its gas-powered counterpart. And it's very interesting. This can get just about any landscaping job done quickly and efficiently. Some are better than others, but if you're starting out or if you're just doing this on a budget, then this is a good choice, I believe. And this is my very first power tool purchase. Not bad for my first power tool purchase. I like it. And I think this will go right well alongside my future power tool purchases, whether they be a power drill or a Sawzall or a jackhammer, all three of which I really want, and I heard they're really, really cool and a lot of fun to use. But you got to be careful with them because they can hurt you. So that's the risk that comes with that, but you got to know the safety aspect of it and how to use it properly. But yeah, this blower is very safe to use and it's very easy. I really like it. Yeah, feels good having your very first power tool. Whether it be a blower like this or a power drill or a reciprocating saw or a circular saw blade or an angle grinder, whatever, you know, power tools can really make very hefty and otherwise time-consuming and boring work significantly much easier. And yeah, this is what landscapers use, as well as ordinary homeowners and even a lot of heavy-duty construction work sometimes when they clean stuff off, and sometimes even car detailers when they wash cars. I mean, this can dry cars off pretty good. So I'm definitely going to use this when I wash cars with Jazzy and possibly with my boss, Danny, as well, because I sometimes wash cars with him in his shop. And possibly, if he gives me permission, to maybe use this to help him clean out his shop if it gets a lot of debris and stuff in there. So this is actually a pretty good addition. I'm liking it. It's actually a lot of fun to use. It definitely makes this a lot more fun, that's for sure. Yeah, I'm liking it. And I'm going to do a test on it momentarily, and I'll be right back. Okay, now that we're outside, we're going to test out my blower. And whoa, look at all this leaf. Look at all these leaves and debris. Yeah, this is not good. Yeah, because when cars and trucks come driving across here, leaves could stick to the tires and possibly cause them to lose control. So that can't be good. So looks like these leaves and stuff have to be cleared out and all that, so stuff like that doesn't slip on these and go into an accident. So it looks like he moved some a little bit, but that's not going to do much. So hey, so I'm gonna have to blow some of these. I don't want to blow them into the road because that would cause quite a bit of a mishap. So then again, this is my first time using this for something like this, so correct me if I'm doing anything wrong, or let me know if I'm doing anything right. I'm just inspecting the area, seeing what needs to be cleared out, but definitely on the sidewalk here, there's a lot of leaves here. I'll probably blow them into the pine straw and the grass right over there. I'll probably do that to start and maybe tackle some of the leaves and stuff right in the center of the road. So I'm gonna go ahead and get her going here. Put my new blower to the test. And here we go. And it's lightweight, so I can film and do this at the same time. There, the leaves are moving around. And then I'm moving to make sure that they'll all flow right over there into the pine straw. Blower's doing pretty good. I'm gonna blow some more right across some here. Sometimes they're ricocheting just a little bit. It actually does pretty good for 200 cubic feet per minute. Yeah. It's getting all this debris pretty good. Except these ones are wet, so they're a little bit stuck to there. Yeah, this is going pretty good. I'm just clearing this area out right here. A few sections at a time. Yeah, and the leaves are going right over there in the pine straw. I think I'm doing a pretty decent job at clearing off the sidewalk. Okay. There's a bit more down there. Yeah, blower's doing a great job so far. Clearing this out pretty good. I'm liking it. It's interesting. Compactness is very easy to use. Wow. This is clearing this really good. I'm liking that. Okay, maybe I'll just do a few more feet along here. And then maybe get some of the leaves on the road. Clear them out so no other cars run them over. Okay, so it looks like there's a lot of leaves right there. So I'm going to get into the center of the road. Then blow them across that way to the sidewalk on that side. Although I'm going to watch for other cars in the process. But yeah, there's a lot of leaves right over here on this side in the center of the road. Yeah, these are a pain in the ass to a lot of drivers. You don't want to run over these, otherwise they'll cause your car to lose control. I'm going to try and blow them away from the road and not into the road. I know that I have no choice but to blow them into the road to get them on the other side like this. Now correct me if I'm doing this wrong, because it's my first time using this for this kind of work here. I'm just testing it out. And no, but I'm not a landscaper in any way, shape, or form. I'm just using this just for fun and stuff, just as a little test. Oh man, there's a lot of leaves right here. I'll probably blow them right onto that side, right in there. There we go. It's not as bad now. Because, hey, this blower's really doing the job. It's really doing the trick. And there's a lot of leaves on this side as well. Okay, it looks like there's more leaves that ricocheted when I made that line going right here. So I'm going to get them hopefully off the road right onto that other sidewalk or so that other cars won't slip on them and stuff. There's a lot of leaves on this side. I'll have to blow them a little bit upstream here. Man, there's a lot. Yeah, that's not good. I'll have to try and get them right up there if I can. It's not going to be easy, but... And again, the wind is pretty strong. The external wind outside, so it's gonna move around a little bit. But I don't know if I'll be able to get all that, but... Should be okay for now. But then again, there's going to be more leaves that are coming along here, making a real mess of this road. And definitely, all the leaves on this side. There's a lot of leaves right here that need to be blown right into there. It's really crazy. Like Mother Nature, you just can't escape it. It just does whatever it wants. Also, gotta watch out for other cars while we're doing so for this. I know that a lot of landscapers do stuff like this for a living, which they have to be really, really careful when they're doing this kind of work in these kinds of environments. Just gotta make sure that these leaves won't make a mess of things. But yeah, this blower's actually doing pretty good at cleaning this area up. I mean, it's not perfect, but it's doing whatever it's doing. It's doing what it can. And it's not 100% clean, but it's getting there. Leaves in the center right here. That's gonna have to be cleared out a bit. I'm not gonna be able to clear all this, but then again, this is just a test. So I'm just trying to see what this new blower can do. And for 200 cubic feet per minute at 90 miles an hour, it's doing pretty good. Too shabby. Not bad. Looks like it's kind of blowing it a little bit that way. The wind, the external wind is. Well, it's not perfect, but it's a decent job for what it is. Yeah, that's definitely one of the main jobs that this thing can do. And there's still a lot of leaves on this sidewalk area here. Man, that is crazy. You just cannot escape Mother Nature. Especially during the fall season, which is right now in this time of year. That's when these leaves start to change color and fall off the trees, and that's definitely why they call it fall. So, I feel like this blower did pretty good for a decent test. And I'm definitely going to keep this. And hopefully add more power tools like this to my collection. I think it does a great job. I like it. The Ryobi 18 volt 1 plus electric power blower. I like it. Great tool. A must-have if you're doing landscaping or debris cleaning or drying off cars even. This is the tool to have. Especially if you're doing this on a budget as well. It does a great job. Yeah, not bad for my first power tool purchase. I like it. It's great. All right, and that concludes the test of my Ryobi 18-volt 1-plus electric power blower. Correct me if I did anything wrong, but also let me know if I did anything correctly as well. But then again, that was my first test, and it did a great job. I'm liking this tool. It's great. It's actually easy to use, and it's also a lot of fun, too. I'm hoping to get more power tools in the future, and I'll definitely make videos on those once ever I get them, so definitely stay tuned. So I'm going to be putting this to work at both my jobs very soon. Hope you all enjoy it.